So what's going on, guys? It's JM, it's Speedboxing. Here. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel before you click on to any of my videos. Also, comment below in the comment section if you guys have any opinions on what I'm saying in any of my videos. Like always, it is appreciated if you guys could drop me a quick sub or two on my channel. So, Adonis Stevenson manages to retain his WBC light heavyweight title after he stops Andrew Fonfara in the second round of their rematch at the Bell Centre tonight in Montreal, Canada. And this was just a demolition job from Adonis Stevenson. He went in there looking to end the fight earlier, looking for the knockout. Just looking to hit Fonfara with the left hand straight away. And he did that straight away. He managed to land the left hand straight away. But he didn't manage to hurt Fonfara until midway through the first round. And then he was just landing that left hand at will. He managed to back Fonfara up into the corner. And he was just hitting him over and over again with the left hand. He didn't even throw a right hand tonight, Adonis Stevenson. If he did, I didn't see it. And he was just hitting him over and over again with the left hand. And the referee obviously jumped in to save Fonfara to get him out of the round because the bell rang. And he was lucky to get out of the round, Fonfara. And then the second round started. And again, Stevenson looking for that big left hand, managed to land it. And Fonfara's defense is just not good at all. Because it was just the same shot over and over again. And Stevenson was just managing to land it at will against Fonfara. Fonfara didn't even really throw anything back at Adonis Stevenson tonight. And Stevenson was just battering him with the left hand. And eventually the referee stopped the fight. And basically Adonis Stevenson just did what he does usually in his fights. Just looking to get the guy out there early. And he did it tonight against Fonfara. I don't even know why this fight happened, to be honest. I don't know why Fonfara was picked for Adonis Stevenson again. Especially since Fonfara has been knocked out in one round by Joe Smith Jr. So I don't understand why he jumped over Joe Smith Jr. And not even that, Stevenson's got a mandatory and Eladio Alvarez has been the mandatory for about a year and a half. I think this guy's fought about three eliminators. He was fighting an eliminator tonight on the undercard again. He beat Jean Pascal by majority decision, Eladio Alvarez. And I think that could be a good fight for Stevenson because it'd be interesting to see how Stevenson would get on, because I think Alvarez could take him some rounds. And it'd be interesting to see at 39 years of age if Stevenson could cope with that, because in his fights he's just looking to end guys early. He hasn't been rounds in a while, Adonis Stevenson. I think the last time he went any rounds was when he fought Saki Obika a few years ago. And at 39 years of age, a lot of people are saying that Stevenson's fading now. And I do see some decline in Adonis Stevenson. He doesn't seem as sharp as he used to be. And after the fight, he did a post-fight interview, but he didn't mention Andre Ward or Sergei Kovalev at all. Adonis Stevenson, this might have just been a tactic not to plug the fight because the fight's happening in 2 weeks. But it was interesting for him not to mention Adonis, not to mention Sergei Kovalev and Andre Ward, I mean, because doesn't he want them fights? Is he just happy to just keep defending his title in Canada against lesser opponents? Because a lot of people see Adonis Stevenson's career as a bit of a joke now, even though he is a world champion, because he hasn't really done anything. He hasn't fought anybody as a world champion, really. He hasn't defended his title against top opposition, and he's a very dangerous fighter for anyone out there, Adonis Stevenson, but he just isn't fighting anyone who's a good enough name, whereas Andre Ward and Sergei Kovalev are fighting each other to unify the division and for pound supremacy. So Adonis Stevenson has definitely become the forgotten champion, and he will continue to be the forgotten champion if he's fighting guys like Andres Fonfara, who, to be honest, didn't deserve the shot against Adonis Stevenson at all. So yeah, comment below in the comment section.